am here today for a bookish discussion with a friend. The book is... Wait, I'm not going to tell you what the book is. It's safe in its book sleeve. So let me invite my friend Priyansh. Okay. One second, everybody.
Hi.
Thank you for not only doing this book discussion with me, but for also for sharing this book with me. It had been on my wish list for a long time, and I'm so happy you gave it to me.
So, you're welcome.
Yeah. So as far as I know, you like this book too, and the book is London, written by Kelly Yang. And this book was so good that I thought of discussing it, fellow bibliophile. So before we begin the discussion, I'd like to give a short summary of this book to our audience. So this book is about Mia Dan, who is a scientist American girl, and Mia and her family are immigrants from China, and they are extremely poor and they have a hard time finding a job. They end up becoming managers in a motel.
The owner of this motel, Mr. Yao, is a horrible man, and I just hate him.
He's like a mean person ever.
So it's about Mia who handles the front desk, and her mom and dad who clean the motel room. So it's basically about Mia trying to make a better life for her whole family. So let me begin the discussion with asking you, why did you like this book? Like, what was your impression?
So basically, I like this book because this book was so inspirational and it talked about the real life struggles about discrimination and racism. Firstly, because her parents and she, they moved from China to America with only $200 in their pocket, and they were struggling so much. So that was like a real eye opener that a lot of people are facing this, and discrimination happens a lot along with racism.
Yeah. So my favorite character is obviously Mia, because she's just so resilient and spunky, and she's full of wonderful ideas. And whenever she sees someone getting discriminated, she stands up for them. So what about you? Who is your favorite character?
Rightly said by you, my favorite character is also Mia. She's my favorite character because she doesn't give up, A, and B, she has really amazing ideas and has really good writing skills. Like that time she wrote letters for many of her family friends when they were in trouble. I really like that part, that even though being from China, she was such a good writer.
Yeah, so Mr. Yao used to say that he's a bad guy. You know, he used to decide by saying that he's a black man, so he's a bad guy. That's stereotyping. What do you say?
Yeah, I think that was really rude of Mr. Yao. That was like really bad racism. Also, I remember in the book, there was this man from the next motel. The security guard from the next motel, he always thought that Hank had stolen the car. So he was also being a lot racist.
Okay, the next. So Hank was accused of stealing the car, right?
Yeah.
And Hank said, "This happens to me all the time."
Yeah.
Why did he say that?
I think he said that because he might have faced a lot of racism in his life just because he was black. Like, you see how when the police came, they instantly suspected that black people were the one who stole the car. But then we find out the owner of the car only did a 30-day special.
So Mia's mother thinks that she should do maths, but Mia likes to rap. So her mother says that English is your second language. You can't be good at English.
Why does she say that? And Mia proves her mother wrong. How?
Like, she basically writes a lot, and her mother said that because she said, your English will never be as good as the native white kid's English. And yeah. I think that was kind of true when she moved there. But after living there for 2 years, she had obviously learned the language of the Americans, and she was like a really fluent writer. That's why she was really good, even though her mother never gave her the opportunity to showcase her skills. That's why she thought that she was not such good writer.
And she put her mother wrong by winning that essay competition in the school, right? She wrote a story and her...
She wrote a small moment that meant a lot to her with two free pizzas. And that was like a real exciting moment for Mia, because she had never had a pizza, or she had never had more than one burger. I remember.
Yeah, so it was a great moment for her. So you remember Lupe, Mia's best friend?
Yeah, I remember.
To each other that they had a golden
golden retriever. Yeah.
So sorry for the interruption.
Yeah. No problem.
What's your favorite part in the story?
My favorite part of the story was when she had the chance to buy the motel that Mr. Ya was selling, and she was like able to raise that much money, because I first thought that there's no way she's gonna raise up $300,000 just for the motel. But then I was like surprised. So what was your favorite part?
It's my favorite part too, when she bought that motel. And Mr. Yao couldn't believe it. Like, how did you get this much money?
Yeah, at first she suspected that as if they had stolen the money.
And he also lied that somebody is offering more money for the motel.
Yeah, I wanted to ask you, which was the part that you felt scared in or you didn't like it?
What I didn't like? Well, yeah. When Mia just took her father's lucky pennies, why did she take it? I mean, she could have thought of another way of gathering money, but why did she sell those? I was just sad.
Yeah, true.
Her father was like not angry, but he was really disappointed.
That sad part was when Mia's mother was beat up by those robbers. But the lucky thing was the doctor, he totally ignored the fees and let them go. But it was a good thing that Mia had collected all the tips for her mother.
Her mother?
It was a good thing that Mia collected all the tips, $150 in the tips for
her
mother.
She was saving that for that essay competition for the motel, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so I was also about to ask that any part you would like to change in the story?
I would certainly change the part when she buzzed in the wrong person and the man was drunk and grabbed her by her collar. I would certainly change
the same part about the selling those pennies. She shouldn't have done that.
Yeah. I had learned a few messages from the story. Did you learn any? And if yes, then which?
What did I learn? Messages?
Like, I learned quite a few messages from this novel. That's what I'm asking.
Oh, you want me to share? Well, yeah. I got about discrimination, how people are treated in this world. It was so bad, and I'm sad for those people. They are treated so unfairly. And it's a message coming out to everyone that everybody is the same, not like black people are different and they are the thieves.
Being unique is what makes us. Being different is what makes us unique. Mine was also the same, like discrimination and the racism.
Stereotyping.
Yeah.
So who was your favorite character after Mia? Like, I think it was Lupe for me.
For me, I think it was Mia's father. He encouraged her to write and he never gave up on her ideas. And even when she sold his lucky pennies, he was really patient and he like supported her that yes, I know you can do it. And he didn't like scold her even.
Yeah. Mia's father was really good too.
Yeah.
Do you know that this book is based on the author's real life event?
Yeah, actually I found out that the author Kelly Yang, it's based upon her real childhood.
Yeah. She must have.
When I found out that, I was like, how sad must it be that you are so young, you have to manage a hotel and deal
yeah,
with
so much racism. So hard for me. I don't think I could ever do that.
Exactly. That's what I thought first.
Well, when the book ended, what did you feel? I definitely felt sad because it's such a great book. I wanted it to go on forever. What about you?
I felt like excited because then in the book they told that a second book was coming out. So I felt excited for one book. Reason because of the sequel. And then I felt also like disappointed that the author has been through so much and that is the way the author is putting it through the story. So I felt disappointed, sad, and also excited at the same time.
Yeah, so the second book is The Three Keys and the third book is Room to Dream, right? I'm sure I'm going to buy it soon.
I don't know about the third book, but I definitely know that the second book is Three Keys. It actually is in 2020 only. Yeah, in May 2020, Three Keys.
Yeah, what were you saying?
Sorry?
Were you saying something? Something wrong with the volume. Yeah, were you saying something? No?
No. Also, I remember the part where she was being teased by Jason and all the popular girls at school for wearing those floral pants. Like, I mean, that's a good thing. They're comfortable. Cotton pants.
Yeah.
But
what's wrong with floral pants? I mean, I feel very uncomfortable with jeans.
Yeah, especially denim jeans. And they all were like, you are so poor, you can't even buy those jeans. And especially the moment when Mr. Yao told that Jason was going to manage the friend desk. I was like about to laugh out loud.
Calculating stuff.
I was literally going to laugh. And then his father got so angry with him and I was like, that's not his mistake. It was his first time. He's in fifth grade. What do you expect from him? He's literally my age.
Oh, I remember one more thing. Like, there was some math challenge in their school and Mia's team said that we got the Chinese girl. They thought that Chinese people are very good at maths.
Yeah,
so
that was also a part of discrimination.
Yeah, but Mia couldn't answer that correctly.
Actually, I think that she was correct. It was the question only. That was
incorrect. I don't know. It was that she didn't answer it correctly. And Jason was so smug after that.
Yeah, he was smirking so much and teasing her and like, I guess I'm better at maths than you now. It's official. So that was like Jason was continuously teasing her every day.
Well, any other thing you'd like to share about the book? Any part did I miss? Anything?
That part, I remember that part very vividly. When Jason took her pencil, her special pencil. $100. But then I especially like the revenge that Mia took coveting that minty thing that made him cry. It was like such a good revenge.
Again, that auditorium.
Yeah. Anything else?
It was. Yeah, and that essay competition about the motel. She didn't win that, but her essay was so nice. I liked it so much. I read it over and over again. That if I had a hotel, I'd treat everybody as family, and I really liked it.
Add bulletproof glass, and then I would add metal gates for parking lots and security cameras, because it was all she had been through, so she didn't want anybody else to go through that.
One takeaway
from the book was that never judge anybody, and also one more takeaway was that never give up in yourself, even though you people might not believe in you, but still never give up. Always try to do your best. That was also a big takeaway from the book for me.
Yeah, and one more thing, Jason said that he took his sparkly pencil and he gave it to his dog, even though he didn't.
Yeah, but that wasn't actually true. He was just trying to tease me.
But she that, really believed him.
Yeah, that was like horrifying if he would have
given it to his dog. But at the end, he gave it back to her.
Yeah, he gave her back. Also, Jason also turned the tables when Mr. Yao found out that they were hiding immigrants in the motel. But Jason saw everything that
Mia's
father was leading the immigrant out of the motel, but he didn't say a word. So that part was really heartwarming that Jason didn't tattletale.
And Mia wrote a thank you letter to him.
Yeah, but she didn't. She said that she won't give it to him because her grandmother said that a heart is like a rubber band. It stretches but snaps back.
But she did give it at the end.
Yeah.
So, anything else? Or should we conclude this?
Yeah, we can conclude.
Okay. So, thank you everyone for watching. Bye. Bye, Priyansh. Thank you for doing this with me.
Yeah, thank you.
Bye. Bye.